奉耶稣圣名，我们继续来谈啊神的任凭。
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us discuss the God's giving of autonomy.
啊，因为这些有基本的概念呢，我们能够清楚读圣经，才不会误解。
So there are a lot of biblical concepts here, so that we do not misunderstand.
有时候神的任凭是为了达到一个更高的一个目的啊，更重要的目的，所以神会有任凭。
So God sometimes gives people autonomy in order to for them to reach a higher purpose.
啊，是有神的他的计划。
And it is because God has His plan.
我们请看出埃及记第七章。
Let us read Exodus chapter 7.
出埃及记七章，我们从第三节来看。
Exodus chapter 7, verse 3.
神说他要使法老的心刚硬。
God said, I will harden Pharaoh's heart.
也要在埃及地多行神迹奇事。
And I will multiply my signs and my wonders in the land of Egypt.
但是法老会不听你们。
But the Pharaoh will not heed you.
所以神要伸手重重的刑罚。
So that I may lay my hand on Egypt.
然后将以色列百姓领出来。
And by great judgments, bring my people out of Egypt.
那第五节说当神把百姓领出来的时候。
And so in verse 5, it says, when the Israelites have been led out from among them,
埃及人就要知道我是耶和华。
The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord.
我们想一想，神为什么要行十个灾祸？他只要做一件事情，应该可以改变。
So let's think of why the Lord needed to send 10 plagues when he could have did it in one.
当然也是因为法老他的心刚硬。
It is because the Pharaoh had his heart hardened.
神也可以行一件神迹就让这个百姓可以出去。
But with only one miracle, God could have led the Israelites out of Egypt.
也有这个可能嘛，这个能力是可以，神是有这个能力的。
That is possible, and God is able to do this.
比如说这个第十灾把它移到第一灾，那就是有一灾而已，没有十灾。
For example, if the tenth plague became the first plague, then there would only have been one plague.
那一方面是因为神的怜悯。
But on the other hand, is the mercy of God.
期待法老能够这个回心转意。
And that he hopes that the Pharaoh would have a change of heart.
好了，但是这个任凭。
But this autonomy that he gives.
人刚硬那神的任凭。
Even though humans harden their hearts, but God still lets them do as they please.
所以一件接一件的神迹一直让百姓看到不管是埃及还是以色列百姓。一直看到神的能力，神的作为，所以更加认识神。
So sign after sign, not only the Egyptians but also the Israelites were able to see the great power and wonder of God.
那这个当中，法老他也差派他的术士行邪术的这些术士呢，也模仿摩西去行了类似的这个神迹。
In some of these early signs.The Pharaoh also used his magicians in order to try to replicate some of these miracles.
但是会产生比对比较，一比较，就让埃及人、让神的百姓就很清楚知道说，那天上的神耶和华才是真正的天上的神，他是天上的神。
But when the magicians' works were compared to the miracles of God, it was very clear that God was the God of heaven and earth.
所以神的任凭有他更高的旨意。
So God's giving of autonomy has his greater purpose.
有他更重要的目的。
Has a more important purpose.
那我们还是要强调有终极的赏善罚恶。
And we must emphasize that in the end there is reward and punishment.
那这个就解释了为什么神不要一下子就把魔鬼给消灭。
And that explains why God does not instantly destroy Satan.
从智慧跟权柄能力来看是没有问题。
From God's wisdom and His power, there is no problem doing so.
可是神为了更高的旨意，更重要的目的。
But God has a greater purpose, and a greater will to not do so.
啊，暂时就任凭魔鬼有一些作为。
So he temporarily allows Satan to do his things.
啊，如果没有黑暗，不会感觉到光明有多重要。
If there was no darkness, then you would not feel the importance of light.
啊，所以魔鬼暂时还存在。
So temporarily, Satan still exists.
啊，也是啊，一方面是让啊世人能够。知道光明的重要，知道真神是哪一位。
On one hand, it is to let the people know who is the real God and the importance of light.
啊，而且也能够让我们产生对神更重、更大的这个信心。
And on the other hand, it is for us to have a greater faith in our God.
那也因为这样，所以会有试验出啊谁的信心是真实的。
And because of this, God is able to test who has real faith.
啊，不管我们下西洋棋还是中国的这个象棋，啊，
Whether,
在下棋的人，他不是只有一个竹子往前推，推，推，推到最后被人家吃掉。他不是，他是全盘的，考虑全盘。他不是只有举起一个棋子，不断的往前走，不是这样。
Whether you play Chinese chess or you play Go, it is not that you can keep pushing the pawn till the end. If you do, it will be taken.
有时候会牺牲一个竹子，一边一卒。
Sometimes you will sacrifice a pawn on each side.
但是造成压迫。
But in order that's to be in a better position.
啊，所以车马炮同时善用，那对方就败了。
If you coordinate the use of your many pieces, then you will find victory.
为了取得最后的胜利。
In order to find the victory at the end.
啊，他下的棋是全盘考虑。
You must consider the entire state of the game.
那我们人活在这个时间。
For us today.
此时此刻此地，看到的是这个范围。
Living in this moment, there are things that We can only see so far.
我们不一定可以看得到全貌。
We might not be able to see the full picture.
所以我们不要代替神去下棋。
So let us not play chess for God.
啊，我们也不要啊这个扮演神的角色。
Let us not take the position of God.
我们没有办法扮演神的角色。
We cannot be in the position of God.
因为我们不是神。
Because we are not God.
啊，当人类第一次要扮演神的角色的时候呢？就把罪引到世界，让后代子孙凄凄惨惨戚戚到现在。
The first time a man tried to play God, they introduced sin into the world, and people suffered for generations.
因为撒旦借着那一条蛇，引发夏娃有一种不合乎真理的欲望。
Because the serpent through Eve introduced this desire that that was against the will of God.
本来那棵树就存在。
The tree had always existed.
他们每天选择都是按着神的话语，所以都是正确。
And every day they chose right in the sight of God.
啊，他们选择不吃，就有神的智慧。
And by choosing not to eat from that tree, they had the wisdom of God.
但是蛇说
，But the serpent said,
你们吃了
，Well, once you have eaten,
变如神，可以像神那样的智慧。
You will be wise like God.
人想要扮演神的角色。
A man wants to take the position of God.
就失败了。
But they failed.
所以很多的遭遇，很多世上看到你不能理解的事情，啊，这是在神的手中掌握，而不是在我们手里。我们应该有这样的一个想法。
So if we see and hear things that we do not understand, we must know that these things are in the control of God.
啊，所以他们是被蛇给迷惑欺骗。
And so they were deceived and they were tricked by the serpent.
啊，当他们在善里面呢，已经具有像神的智慧了。
When they were doing good, they already had the wisdom of God.
啊，但是被迷惑，所以犯罪。
But being deceived, they sinned.
好，那我们接着再来看一看哈。
Let us continue to see.
我们一下子要讲到从第七章再讲到十四章。
We'll go from chapter 7 to 14.
我们来看就是摩西他啊，神行十件神迹哈。那这个埃及的法老他也 派了一些术士也是行神迹。
So, God has performed 10 miracles, but the Egyptians also use their magicians.
那到底这有什么差别？
So what is the difference here?
看起来好像一样。
It seems that they did the same things.
那现在我们就是要，因为我们也谈到灵界辩证的话题。
Because we also have a class on discerning spirits.
那现在底下要谈的这正好也是可以看为是灵界辩证的话题之一。
So this is an extension of that class.
所以两个科目就同时来讲。
So let's talk about both classes at once.
我们可能都会看到有一些灵媒一些异教灵媒，他们也会行一些奇事异能。
So we may see some people from other beliefs that may perform miracles.
那这些跟神所行的神迹有什么不一样？
So what's the difference between those miracles and the miracles performed by God?
我们要怎么样去解读？
How can we discern between these signs?
我们可以从三个方面来看。
We can look at it from three perspectives.
所以当你看到有一个乩童啊，灵媒他行了一件好像类似神迹，是一个奇事。你不要被迷惑。
So if we see a medium or a witch do a miraculous sign, then we should not be surprised.
那这个法则也可以去应用到我们在灵界做判断。
We should not be confused, and we can use these as a basis for spiritual discernment.
就是说，它最后的结果是什么？
So what is the result of their signs?
这样的一个奇事，它最后可能导致的结果是什么？
What is the result of them performing these miracles?
那这是他的目的啊。那他的效果怎么样呢？
And what is the effect of these miracles?
还有它的来源是什么？
And what is the source of their miracles?
那天我们在讲，到底是鬼附还是精神病患？
So we were saying in the past couple of days, was it a mental issue or was it a spiritual issue?
我们也是提醒说，要回去检讨那个。起因是什么？
We discussed that when we encounter these problems, we need to go look at the source.
所以我们可以来看一看啊，源头来源是什么
？So for many for these things as well, we can take a look at what the source is.
我们看第七章的第八节。
Let us read chapter 7 verse 8.
七章八节。
Chapter 7 verse 8.
神晓谕摩西亚伦说。
The Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron.
你们去见法老，如果他们对你们说，你行一件神迹奇事吧。
When Pharaoh speaks to you, saying, "Show a miracle for yourselves."
那你就吩咐亚伦说，把他的杖丢在法老的面前。
Then you shall say to Aaron, "Take your rod and cast it before Pharaoh."
使杖变作蛇。
And let it become a serpent.
所以神迹的来源是哪里呢
？So what is the source of miracles?
神迹的来源不是人。
The miracles are not from man.
是从神来的。
They are from God.
所以现在这个神迹是神吩咐的摩西被动领受神的命令。
And so this miracle was performed by command of God through Moses.
那虽然这个杖是亚伦丢下去了。
That even though this rod was thrown down by Aaron.
但是这个神迹来源并不是亚伦。
But the source of this miracle was not from Aaron.
亚伦不过是在这个神迹的过程中的一个器皿。
Aaron is but a vessel for this miracle.
因为亚伦是一个人。
Because Aaron is a human.
他不是神。
He is not God.
包括这个十件神迹也是一样。
Similar for the other 10 plagues.
都是从神来的。
They all come from God.
既然是出于神。
And since they come from God,
一定有神的旨意。
They must have God's purpose within them.
我们看希伯来书第二章。
Let us read Hebrews chapter 2.
希伯来书第二章。
Hebrews chapter 2.
我们常常想说，哎呀，主啊，你为什么不多行一些神迹奇事呢？慕道者就很多了。
Sometimes we wonder why God does not perform more miracles. Perhaps we may have more truth seekers.
第二章第四节。
Chapter 2, verse 4.
希伯来书二章四节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 4.
我们大家一起读。
Let's read together.
开始。神又按自己的旨意，用神迹奇事，按百般的异能，并圣灵的恩赐，同他们做见证。 所以神迹是出于神，源头是从神来的。
So the source of miracles comes from God.
我们说神迹就是神的作为。
We see miracles are the doings of God.
那有时候人也想说，向神来求，可不可以有神迹显明？
So sometimes we might wonder if we can pray for God to show His miracles.
好像说我们传道人长职啊，长职传道要按为信徒按手，为慕道者按手。我们希望为他来祈求啊，恩典福气，或是说求神将圣灵赐给他。
So when elders and ministers lay hands on people, they pray that the people may receive blessings or receive the Holy Spirit.
那当然，这个是本来就是神的应许了。
And this is a promise of God.
啊，也是圣经的教导嘛。
And this is a teaching of the Bible.
啊，那虽然现在呢是人去把它发动。
And so even though it is the movement of man,
但是也是遵照神的吩咐跟他的应许，在他的应许里面我们去做这个事。
But these people they move according to God and they do as instructed by God.
啊，因为他应许啊，要用神迹奇事随着。来证实我们所传的道。
Because through these miracles, they are able to uphold the truth that we preach.
哦，那么他也应许信他的人从他的腹中要流出活水的江河，啊，就是应许的圣灵。
They have it also allows for the people who believe to have springs of living water, which is the promised Holy Spirit.
但是这个时候要看神的旨意。
But this depends on the will of God.
啊，因为神迹是出于神。
Because miracles come from God.
啊，现在我们主动要为他来按手。
So now we lay hands on people.
要看神的旨意。
And we lay hands by God's will.
也就是说，成全的方式。
And that is to say the method of fulfillment.
成全的时候。
And the time of fulfillment.
不一定是今天。
It may not be today.
不一定是明天。
It may not be tomorrow.
神有他的时候。
God has his time.
他应许把圣灵赐给我们。
He has promised the Holy Spirit for us.
在什么情况底下呢？
Under what conditions?
在什么样的时候呢？
And when does he promise?
啊，神的旨意。
That is up to God.
但是祷告或按手是我们的义，我们的本分。
But to pray and to lay hands, that is our duty.
那神一定会将圣灵赐给我们。
The Lord will give the Holy Spirit to us.
啊，有一个初信的这个弟兄啊。
There was a new believer.
因为他的太太先到教会来信主。
Because his wife came to church, believe first.
那一段时间，他的先生才来。
才
到教会来。
And then his her husband arrived to the church later at a later point.
啊，他的先生是啊患了癌症啊，而且是癌末。
And the husband was facing terminal cancer.
那就到教会慕道也受洗了。
And being a truth seeker, he became baptized at the church.
一直祷告，求不到圣灵。
And he kept praying, but he was not able to receive the Holy Spirit.
已经住到这个医院的安宁病房了。
And he is already sent to the terminal care patient care.
哦，那就是到最后的阶段了。
And that is the end of the end.
啊，他心里也没什么害怕，唯一的就是说啊，主耶稣啊，你什么时候圣灵赐给我呢？
He had no fears left, but he was wondering whether the Lord would give him the Holy Spirit.
啊，到他要离世的那一天。
Until the day he was about to pass.
哎，他的太太白天都是在安宁病房陪伴他。
His wife would accompany him during the daytime.
啊，到了下午的时间呢，他的太太说：“我先回去啊，家里拿一个东西，我再过来。”
In the afternoon, the wife said, "I will get something from home and I'll come back."
那在病房里，只要有时间，他们夫妻两个人就一起祷告。
And in the medical ward, while they have time, they will pray together.
那他在回家的时候，啊，这位弟兄呢，他也继续在病房里面祷告求圣灵。
While he was in the ward, the brother would continue to pray for the Holy Spirit.
他太太来的时候啊，他就告诉他太太说。你刚刚回家，我自己祷告，我领受圣灵了。
And when the wife came back from home, the brother told the wife, "I have received the Holy Spirit while I was praying."
哦，他太太啊，是因为太惊奇了，所以啊，一下子没有办法去相信啊。他求了很久的时间，现在圣灵是给他天生了，他反而不相信，这个很奇，这因为太惊奇了。
But the wife was perhaps too surprised, so she did not believe the husband when he said that he received the Holy Spirit.
来祷告。
So the wife said, "Oh, let's come and pray."
感谢主，真的领受圣灵。
And thank God, he truly has received the Holy Spirit.
那是下午黄昏的时候了。
And that was by twilight.
那天晚上，这个弟兄就走了。
And at that evening, the brother passed away.
就安息。
And he passed in peace.
主的应许一定会成就。
The promises of God will be fulfilled.
不知道什么时候。
You do not know when.
因为它是他的旨意。
Because that is up to God.
不是在我们预定的时间，也不是我们所期待的方式。
It is not a time we set or in a way that we expect.
所以神的旨意在什么情况、什么方式、什么时间去成就，是有他的计划。
So when, where, and how, God's plan will be fulfilled is up to Him.
但是他既然应许，一定不会落空。
But if He has promised so, then it will not, it will always happen.
那甚至我们可以这么理解。
And so we can understand it in this way.
我们不能够清楚明白。
We may not understand all of his plans.
那既然这是神对人的一个约定，给人的一个承诺。
But because this is a promise from God to man,
我们今天信主，主耶稣一定会把圣灵赐给我们。
So we must believe that God will give us the Holy Spirit.
但是我们要尽本分的求。
But we must do our duty of praying for it.
我们讲这些见证是安慰我们，要鼓励大家继续来祈求。
And these testimonies we speak in order to encourage everyone to continue their prayers.
因为我们早一点领受圣灵，对我们有很大的帮助。
To receive the Holy Spirit early has many benefits.
我们直接体会到神的存在。
We may directly experience the presence of God.
坚固我们的信心。
To strengthen our faith.
在生活中随时圣灵随时作为我们的保惠师。
That the Holy Spirit may become our counselor and guide in our daily lives.
对于我们做圣工，对于我们读圣经都有很大的帮助。
That in doing holy work and when you read the Bible, there will be many benefits.
也可以帮助我们结出圣灵的果子。
And can help you bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
我们不能够说一定会赐给我，所以我反正我现在不祷告临终以前再来祷告就好了。
So,
不知道什么时候要临，什么时候是叫做我们的临终，不知道。
So let us not say, let us wait until we are in terminal care, that then we pray, because you do not know when you will die.
有一个弟兄他患病了，住院了。
There was a brother who became ill and he was admitted to the ward.
他也求圣灵，求了很久的时间。
And having prayed for the Holy Spirit for a long time.
有一个传道人到那个国家要去工作。
And one day, a pastor went to that country to work.
那下飞机的时候呢，这个负责人就说那个弟兄在住院。
After he got off the plane, the council member told the pastor that this brother was in the hospital.
那传道人因为这个工作职业的敏锐度够他说好，下飞机我们现在直接先去医院帮他祷告。
So the pastor said, after he got off the plane, let us.Then go directly to the hospital and we'll pray for him.
那这次去的时候就帮他按手祷告。
And this time, when he went to the hospital, he laid his hands on him.
他也在病房里面呢得到圣灵。
And in the hospital ward, the brother received the Holy Spirit.
不久也安息。
And not long after he passed.
所以我们清楚知道。
So we know clearly.
还有一个领受圣灵的时间跟他离开。跟他安息的时间非常的靠近。
We know that the time between receiving the Holy Spirit and his passing were very close.
这个弟兄已经到了弥留状态，就是快离世了。
And the brother was already in a close to passing state.
那家里的人就聚集说：“好了，我们最后一次来祷告吧。我们好像是圣徒要送行嘛，差不多了。医生也是差不多，他应该要走了。”我们家族的人就一起最后一次祷告，在祷告中为他送行。
So, the family decided to gather together and do one last prayer together as if to send him off.
就在祷告的时候就大家都听到有一个以前没有听过的那个声音在讲灵言就是那个病人这个病人的声音他的祷告转换成灵言
So during the prayer, the family noticed a sound they haven't heard before, and which was this patient, and he was speaking in tongues.
大家很高兴。
And everyone was filled with joy.
那祷告就结束了。
And after the prayer concluded,
大家很高兴啊。
Everyone was very joyful.
是只有真耶稣教会信徒啊，即将要走的时候，大家才会高兴。
Only in true Jesus church will you find people who are happy about others passing.
哎，因为圣灵的安慰啊，他领受圣灵啊，啊不没有几分钟啊，啊没有几分钟他就安息了。
Because not only a few minutes after he received the Holy Spirit did he pass away.
那这是我们看得见的。
And this is something we can see.
就在他眼前啊发生的。
It happened before our eyes.
所以我们知道说哦，主耶稣把圣灵赐给他。
So we know that the Lord has indeed given the Holy Spirit to them.
但是主耶稣要用什么方式，在什么情况底下，不见得都是我们眼见的时刻，不是都是我们眼睛可以看得到的时候。
But for a lot of signs and miracles, it is not something that we can see directly with our eyes.
哎，主的应许一定不会落空。
But we know that the promises of God will not be empty.
所以我们不要怀疑。
So let us not doubt.
但是我们一定要用心的来祷告。
But we must pray fervently.
好，那现在这样看起来就会清楚知道了。
So now it becomes clear to us.
你从来源去探讨。
If we look at something from afar.
是不是出于神的？
Is it from God?
啊，真正的神迹是从神来的。
A real miracle should come from God.
啊，但是邪灵也会行一些异能奇事。
Evil spirits can also perform signs.
啊，他们也有。邪灵也有在一个范围里面的权柄能力。
Within a certain bound, the evil spirit also has some power.
那我们看一下哈，这个刚刚的出埃及记第七章。
Let us go back to Exodus chapter 7.
十一节。
Verse 11.
好，这个亚伦把杖丢在法老的面前呢，这个杖就变成蛇。
And so when Aaron cast down his rod, it became a serpent.
那十一节呢，这些术士呢？啊，是埃及行法术的。
And the Pharaoh called the sorcerers of Egypt.
也用邪术照样而行。
And they did so with their enchantments.
所以有一些歧视也是可以从邪灵而来。
So evil spirits can also perform signs.
啊，可是我们要知道哦，这个目的是什么呢？
But we must know what their purpose is.
那这样他们这样行的目的是要对抗神。
The purpose of this sign is to oppose God.
因为撒旦本来就是对抗神的。
Because Satan is to oppose God.
啊，敌对神，而且要迷惑人。
To oppose God and to confuse the people.
用假的来乱这个真的。
With the false, they try to confuse the truth.
啊，那个果效怎么样呢？
What is the fruit of this?
他那个果效是被限制的。
The result is that they are restricted.
哦，比如说他是复制。它不是开创。
Because they copy effects and they do not, they do not.
包括后来十项神迹里面。
They are not novel, and including the 10 plagues later.
这些灾祸里面，十灾里面呢，术士也要仿效，要 copy， 要学习。
Because the sorcerers also try to copy the 10 plagues.
但是他只能够复制某一个部分，他没有办法全部。
But they can only copy part of it and not the whole.
而且它的效用不长久。
And their effects are not lingering.
并且它是没有办法跟神来对抗。
And they are not able to oppose God.
啊，一样是变成蛇。
And they similarly, their rod became a serpent.
它是仿效的。
And it is a mimic.
短暂存在。
It lasts for a short time.
然后被吞吃。
And has been swallowed.
所以出于神的才更加的。完全。
So what comes from God is more perfect.
啊，是胜过邪灵所行的。
It overpowers that of the evil spirit.
那我们就不要担心呐。
And so we have nothing to fear.
哦，暂时他们会有暂时的果效。
That the evil spirit's powers have temporary power.
但是他的目的是要迷惑人。
But their purpose is to confuse people.
是要来对抗神。
Is to oppose God.
那我们就可以用这三个原则去看很多很多。如果我们一时没有办法去分辨的，我们从这三个方面去看。
With these three principles, if we cannot discern between signs, then we should look at it these ways.
这也是我们平常可以去做一个思考。
And this is something that we can ponder upon.
啊，如果是有一些你没有办法分辨的，但是好像这一件事情很特别。
But if it's something that we cannot discern, but it seems very special.
不一定就是行了一件奇事，类似神迹的这样奇事。
It may not be that something that happened is clearly a sign or a miracle from God.
好像有一个人突然间就讲了一些话。
It could be that someone has said something.
突然间发生了一件事情。
Maybe something has happened.
有一种现象出现。
A special occurrence has happened.
那我们要去看。
Then we need to go.
是不是对抗神的？
Does it go against God?
是不是在敌对神，跟神在对抗的？
Does it oppose God directly?
这个事情是不是要来混乱真道的？
Is it meant to confuse the truth?
那我们要去看。
Then we need to observe.
也可以去分辨出来是不是出于神。
And we can discern whether or not it comes from God.
虽然它不一定是一件奇事。
Even though it might not be a miracle,
它是一个事件或是一个现象。
It's a sign or a it's a sign.
因为在末世的时候这类似这种事情很多。
And the end times, these things will become more common.
那在摩西的时代呢，这种事情就已经是非常混乱了。
In even Moses' time, these things were very chaotic already.
从神来的神迹就是出于神的力量。
Signs and miracles from God come from the power of God.
那如果不是出于神的，是一些人的力量。
But if it does not come from God and it comes from man,
或是邪术的力量。
Or it comes from an evil spirit.
那就是从邪灵而来。
Then that comes from Satan.
那邪恶的力量怎么能够对抗神的力量呢？
How can evil oppose God?
那它的效果也是一样。
And their effects are the same.
它是有限的。
They are limited.
没有办法去对抗无限的。
They cannot oppose the infinite God.
这些邪灵的力量是被限制的。
Their powers are being limited.
但是神的能力是无限的。
But God, His power is unlimited.
它是无限的全能。
He is omnipotent.
我们做了这些比较就会清楚知道了。
And when we do this comparison, it will be clear to us.
很多的使徒都告诉我们说，在这个末世的时候。
Many apostles have told us.
灵，那个混乱的灵，假先知的灵已经出现。
That in the end times, the spirit of the Antichrist has already appeared.
2000年前是这样。
2000 years ago, they said this.
何况2000年后的今天。
And the 2,000 years today, it is the same for us.
所以我们一定要谨慎来做分辨。
So we must be careful in our discernment.
但是我们不要害怕。
But we must not be afraid.
没有任何一寸的黑暗不是被光明给驱走的。
Not an inch of darkness will not be swallowed by the light.
任何的黑暗都是被亮光给赶走。
Every inch of darkness can be shown upon by light.
邪恶不能够胜过天上的神。
The evil of this world cannot overcome the light of God.
神有暂时的任凭。
That God has allowed them autonomy for now.
但是至终会显出他的公义。
But in the end, He will exact His justice.
我们要对神更有信心。
We must have faith in God.
那我们。所以今天讲的出埃及记，小弟就想说，我们就先讲到这个地方。
So I think that we should speak to this point for Exodus.
那这样一下子就跳到14章了。
So now we have jumped all the way to chapter 14.
那接着我们明天最后我们再谈有关于这个律法的应用十条诫命的应用，还有一些会幕的真理，我们再重点提示一下。
So tomorrow we will talk a little bit about the Ten Commandments and the Tabernacle.
同心默祷。
Let us pray in silence.